Hello and welcome to Yelo. So Yelo is a platform that helps small business to get an online presence in a few minutes. Yelo can elevate your business as it is quick to set up and works on multiple platforms to help you grow your business on the. Here's how you can actually log in. You'll have the user ID and the password, and after logging in, so this is the Yelo admin panel that you would land up. Now Yelo has this thing that Yelo dashboard gives you an option to add merchants and manage your orders and customers. In the Yelo dashboard, you will have the option as named as merchants. You can click and you'll get to add different merchants, and you'll have the option to search about the merchant. Here you can actually filter the merchant according to your preference, and here's how you can add a new merchant to the existing list. Yelo offers you to add multiple or a single aggregator marketplace. In multiple aggregator you can add various merchants, and in single aggregator you'll have one marketplace from where you'll operate. So here we have store names. So these are the four stores that we have. Here's the address for these stores, the phone number, the email ID. Here we do have an option of rating the merchants, the status, whether they're online or offline, and from the action we can actually block or delete the existing merchants. The merchant, the first merchant that you have, is you can only edit it but not delete it, and rest of the merchants you can actually block or delete. Now clicking on the first merchant, we'll have three options here: configuration, catalog and merchant. Now in the merchant we'll have all the details of the merchant. First of all, we have the ID that is automatically generated and you cannot edit it. The name of your marketplace, that is the restro. Suppose this is the demo, so we have the name as restro demo. And here is the store name that you would write. The email ID, the phone number of the store, the address of the store, and what is the display address, what you want your customers to see. The status. The description, you can actually describe your store in maximum of 60 characters. The serving radius, you can edit the logo, upload your logo and banner image from here. And this is the rating option that we have. Here is the sponsorship that you can actually add the sponsorship and the regarding details about the sponsorship, that the date range, the start and the end time. Now clicking on the catalog, we have various options to add the menu of the restaurant. Here we can change the view of the restaurant, that whether we want to have the list view or the grid view. From here we can actually import the catalog of the pre-existing merchant that we had. And here is the option, you again get the option of add merchant from here. From here you could actually filter out that what items you want to show. Now going on to the category, we could add different categories according to the merchant, what all we need to have. The categories give you the option of adding products to the categories. So here's the example. Suppose you click on the category of tossed salads, we have two products under it, the Caesar salad and the green salad, and so on. And then we have the option of editing the category. Here's how you can edit the category, the name, you can have the description or the any taxes applicable to it, and you can also add the images from to the required category item. Now we could disable or delete the existing business category. If you want to delete it, here's the option, and if you want to disable it for some time, you could actually disable it. Now here's how we add the business category for the existing merchant, And then going on to the products, we could add the product from here and we could search the product. And clicking on the product, we get the option of deleting the product, editing the product. So on edit, we actually get to edit the product name. We could set the price of the product. The minimum, you could also set the minimum quantity to that you could order. The cost price, you could actually maintain the inventory, the taxes, and if you're enabling the inventory option, you'll have to mention the available quantity of the items that you have, the description of the item, and you could also have the long description of the item. And here's how you add the image of the particular product. Now going on to the variants option, you could actually have variants and add-ons. Suppose you want to have the add-on of anything, the quantity, you could have the quantity variant, and you could actually ask your customers whether it would be a single select or a multiple select. And the type, suppose you have 50 grams and you could enter the price. And you could also have it as a default option, or you could add more variants. So this is how you add the variants. Here you can see the quantity. We have two variants and add-ons, the cheese option and the quantity option. And here's how you disable the product. Now here you could see the product details. You could refresh it to refresh the inventory or the quantity. And here's how the product would be shown. Now going on to the third option that we have here is configuration. So in configuration, we have the different options, such as date-wise availability, when would your merchant be available, whether he would be available every day or on specific days. We'll have the time-wise availability, whether he would be available full-time or for specific time. You could actually choose what specific time or the slot he wants to be available in. And here's how you could do the scheduling part, the whether you want to have the option of on-demand or the scheduling. Here's how you allow the business category that we had the option earlier to choose the business category. We have the buffer option here that yes, how much time you want in minutes. You could set the time so that your slot would appear after that time. Here you can also set the minimum order quantity or order amount that you want your customers to order. Then we have the maximum order per slot. Here you can actually set the maximum order that you want your customers per slot to order. Now this is the option of catalog that yes, you could, if you're actually maintaining the inventory, you could actually show out of stock items to your customers. Here's how you can add the discounts that you want to give to your customers. Suppose you have the discount name as new, you could actually set the value. It could be a fixed or a percentage amount. You could have the description and the validity that you could give to your customers. You could edit it, delete it, or disable it. Then you have the option for email notification that your customer would get that their order is placed or not. Then here we have the workflow. Here you can actually select the product marketplace or the service marketplace. This is a very important option in our platform. Then we have the option of one booking per time slot. So whether you want one booking per time slot or you want to have multiple bookings per time slot. Then here's the option of multiple products or services in a single cart. How many products you want your customers to have, multiple products in a single cart, or you want your product your customers to have one product in a single cart. Then we have the option of product multi-selection that you can, when you enable the this option, then your users can select multiple quantity of the same product. And if we disable it, the customers are not allowed to select the multiple products. Then we have the checkout template. Here's it is all custom, and you could actually customize it that what all information you want from your customers when they're checking out for the required order. Thank you.